Hello friends, welcome back to our channel ABC04. This is lecture number 4 and in this we will be discussing about low temperature preservation and some freezing methods. Low temperature provides a significant extended shelf life and has been successfully employed for long-term preservation of many foods. Freezing is still one of the most widely used methods of food preservation. The freezing of foods slows down but does not stop the physicochemical and biochemical reactions that govern the deterioration of foods. During storage, there is a slow progressive change in organoleptic quality, which does not become objectionable for some time. Low temperature preservation is done to prevent the growth and activity of microorganisms, to prevent post-harvest metabolic activity of intact plant tissues, and post-slaughter metabolic activity of animal tissue. It retards the chemical changes like oxidative browning. Also, it reduces the water activity. Low temperature preservation of food can be achieved by two methods. First is by refrigeration or chilling. It is a unit operation in which the temperature of a food is reduced to between 1 degree centigrade and 8 degree centigrade. It is used to reduce the rate of biochemical and microbiological changes and hence to extend the shelf life of fresh and processed foods. It causes minimal changes to sensory characteristics and nutritional properties of food. Second method is freezing. It is also a unit operation in which the temperature of a food is reduced below its freezing point and water undergoes a change in state to form ice crystals. Now we will see the chilled foods, which are grouped into three categories. First category, between minus 1 degree centigrade to plus 1 degree centigrade. It includes fresh fish, meat, sausages and ground meat, smoked meats. Second category is between 0 degree centigrade to plus 5 degree centigrade. It includes pasteurized canned meat, milk, cream, yogurt, sandwiches, baked goods, fresh pasta, fresh soup and sausages, pizza and unbaked dough. Third category is between 0 degree centigrade to plus 8 degree centigrade. It includes fully cooked meats and uncooked cured meats, butter, hard cheese, cooked rice, fruit juices and soft fruits. Now we will see methods of fruit freezing. There are three basic freezing methods in commercial use. First is freezing in air, second is by indirect contact with refrigerant, and third is freezing by direct contact with refrigerant. In freezing in air, the cold air may be used with various degrees of velocity, progressing from still air sub freezing to high velocity blast freezer. The velocity of air also may be used to subdivide and move particles of food to be frozen, as in the case of fluidized bed freezing. In indirect contact freezing, it includes those methods in which food packages is in contact with surface, which is cooled by refrigerant, but food or food package does not contact the refrigerant directly. In direct contact, it involves the direct contact of food with refrigerant, either by submerging the food or by spraying cold liquid onto the food or package surfaces. In freezing in air, there are three types of freezer, namely still air freezer, blast air freezer, fluidized bed freezer. In second, that is freezing by indirect contact, we have single and double plate freezer and slush plate freezer. In freezing by direct contact with refrigerant, we have immersion type and second is cryogenic freezer. Now we will see it one by one. A still air freezer. It is also known as chest freezer. Velocity is slow and rate of freezing is slow. Range is maintained between minus 23 degree centigrade to minus 30 degree centigrade. It is a cheap and defrosting is required. Food packs are stored in the freezer in such a way that air can circulate between the packages. Second is blast air freezer. In this, blast of chill air is passed with velocity of 1.5 to 6 meter per second. Range is between minus 3 degree centigrade to minus 40 degree centigrade for 15 to 10 minutes. The simplest form of blast cooling is the batch cabinet chiller or freezer. A batch of food is placed in a cabinet, usually on trays, on trolleys, or it can be hung also. Cooled air is blown over the food and circulated. More advanced type is a continuous tunnel cooler or freezer where the food is conveyed by trolleys or conveyor belts. One variation of continuous belt freezer is the spiral freezer in which the food is conveyed on a spiral flexible mesh belt. Third is fluidized belt freezer. The cold air is used both to cool and to fluidize a bed of particulate food. This mechanism has the advantage of freezing the particles individually. Food is contact with the chilled air blast, which is sufficiently strong to lift the product. Another is plate freezer. The plate freezer consists of a hollow cells cooled by a refrigerant evaporating inside them. The food is pressed between the plates. This ensures good contact between the cold surface of the plate and the food. Freezing time depends on the thickness of the product between the cells. In single plate, food is frozen from one side, and in double plate, food is frozen from both sides. Slush freezer. In this, freezing is never completely done, as it can froze the food, which can choke the tube. Instead, the food is frozen to the slush condition. Mainly, liquid or semi-solid food is used, which can easily pump through heat exchanger and pass through the cold wall of the tube. Rapidly revolving scraper or knife is fitted, which automatically scraps the wall so that food does not adhere on it. Immersion freezer. In this, liquid is used as a refrigerant, which does not change its state. Packaged or unpackaged food is passed through a bath of refrigerant. Glycerol, glycol, brine, sugar, mixture of salt and sugar can be used for freezing. For example, 3% of NaCl with a 62% sugar solution can lower the melting point of food by minus 20 degrees centigrade. Similarly, 67% glycerol can bring the temperature down around minus 47 degrees centigrade. Cryogenic freezing. The word cryogenic is related to the branch of physics that deals with the production and effects of very low temperature. In cryogenic freezing, it refers to the process in which the material to be frozen is in direct contact with cryogens. For example, solids, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and freon 12. Cryogenic liquids are liquefied gases of extremely low boiling point, such as liquid nitrogen and liquid carbon dioxide, with boiling points of minus 196 centigrade to minus 79 degrees centigrade respectively. Today, liquid nitrogen is most commonly used in this type of freezing. Now we will see the pictures of some freezers. Here is chest freezer, blast air freezer, fluidized breast freezer, slush freezer, plate type freezer, immersion freezer. You can see how it works in this diagram. Cryogenic freezer. Important properties of refrigerants. Some of important properties are: it may have low boiling point, it has high latent heat of vaporization, it should be have low toxicity, it should be non-inflammable, and very important, it should have low cost and also low miscibility with oil in compressor. Now we'll see what are the factors which affect refrigeration. First is air velocity. The air should be circulating in the freezer. Second, relative humidity, which is very important. Third is storage area. Fourth is light installation. The freezer should have proper light installed. And fourth is number of people working and how often doors are opened which permit entrance of warm air in the cold storage. So thank you for watching, and please like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.